morning, everyone.
Good morning.
That was downtown this morning, and got an opportunity to talk to CD5 folks, and it was really wonderful, fun, and I had a great time this week at the CD2 candidates forum. My name is Don Allen, and this is going to be the first time that some of you have heard my name. I'm running for the chairman of the Minnesota GOP, and I need the delegates, I need everybody's support in this room. Because if we continue, as Republicans, to go down the same path of the status quo, and voting the person in who looks like the chairman of the Minnesota GOP, we're headed toward extinction. I'll put it like that softly. And extinction because in the 4th CD and the 5th CD, we're in a combat zone. We're behind enemy lines. You had a great candidate over here in 2008, Ed Matthews, running against Betty. And Betty pretty much, you know, did the thing and won. But there wasn't really a lot of support for Mr. Matthews. I was running Barb Davis White's campaign in the 5th Congressional District. I'm still waiting for a callback from the Minnesota GOP headquarters from 2008. You know, I have spider webs on my ear and the phone up there, and still have not gotten a call back. Now, some of you in here have decided that Keith Downey, Paulson, or one of the other people, that's your candidate. That's the guy that I'm going to choose because he looks like the person that we want there. But the thing is, you have to look at the media. There's media, money, and motivation. The three M's, I call it. You have to have a plan. We have not been able in the Minnesota Republican Party in Minnesota to exercise any media here. There are more than a million Republicans in Minnesota. You guys can agree with that, right? More than a million. We haven't figured out how to get $1 from each of them. And that's a shame. When you look at what the Democrats here are doing, the promises DFL is making, the places that Governor Dayton ends up in, I'm in rooms all the time in North Minneapolis, South Minneapolis, St. Paul, and the lone Republican in the room. Governor Dayton's sitting there. Some of these community leaders are sitting there from all, represents all, and I'm almost done, all parts of the community. And there are no Republican representation there. There are no activists. You know, we come out for a convention and we wait till next couple of years and we come out to another convention. In between there, you have the DFLers out there making promises. You know, why can't the Republican Party and the elected Republican officials and state legislators decide that we're going to address education, we're going to address unemployment, we're going to debunkle the 32% set by the Commissioner of Human Rights, one of Mark Dayton's boys, to define who works and who can continue to work. Veterans, I'm a veteran. I'm actually a student at Hamline University. And I watched some of my fellow veterans in the Hamline University Veterans Affairs Organization literally cry when they found out that the military was cutting to $4,500 a year. So there was no Republican to run to and talk to, elected official. There was no Democrat to run to. And these people were Republicans, at least they tell me that. And since we need some kind of buffer out there that our people, it's always been with the Republican Party from the time of Booker T. Washington, Du Bois, and those others, and mind you, I'm not here to get minorities in the party. I'm here as a business person to address some of the significant fall-offs they've had by lack of process that would maintain an even flow and rise to the station of even being a Republican and understanding the core principles, which everybody in Minnesota can agree with. But yet we have this stigma that it is not well. You're gonna hear Keith Downey, they have beautiful signs printed up. I haven't asked anybody in the state of Minnesota for a penny and will not print up a sign. I will not waste that money that should be going to the Minnesota GOP. In closing, your delegates in here, I want you to carefully consider who you vote for. I want you to carefully consider the future. 2013 and 2014 are very important years. If we let this go by with the wrong leadership in the Minnesota GOP, you can expect some things to happen that you've never seen before, and it's not going to hold well for us. Again, thank you. My name is Don Allen. I'm running as chair of the Minnesota GOP. Have a great day.